Global warming may get us in 20 years. Nuclear war can get us in 20 minutes. I just don't want to see humanity become extinct.
It is a race against time to save our humanity.
This really is the greatest security challenge facing us today.
The nuclear threat is a global threat.
Ted called me and said, I thought the Cold War was over, and here we are. We've got a huge number of nuclear weapons. We still have a Cold War type alert posture. Why don't we do something about it? He said, I'm willing to put up money if you're willing to give your time, and let's do something about reducing nuclear risk in the world. So that was how it started.
The Nuclear Threat Initiative is committed to the mission of strengthening global security by reducing the risk of nuclear and other weapons of mass destruction.
You can't have nuclear security and a sense of protection of nuclear facilities and material and know-how without the Nunn-Lugar program. And having the nun of the Nunn-Lugar program as the head of NTI gives us the most credibility you could have in the world.
We thought at that time that our biggest challenge was going to be to convince the American people that there was a threat of terrorism. It could become nuclear, biological, or chemical terrorism. All of a sudden, 9/11 had changed that.
The Nuclear Threat Initiative has been one of the leaders in focusing on the risks that arise from nuclear arsenals that states have and nuclear weapons usable material that states make, because you could have not just a 9/11, but a nuclear 9/11.
It's tough raising money for reducing nuclear risk in the world. We knew we had to get some people who really were passionate about it, who understood the risk, and we've been very fortunate to have that.
If you look at the board of NTI, it includes important and influential individuals in other countries, and they also have represented the views of NTI in Russia or in China or in India. So in that sense, it's had an impact more broadly.
We were very lucky to recruit to NTI some very top-level professionals from the outset.
What I like about the way NTI operates, they want to hear all the views, and they try to bring them together in initiatives that unite us all.
We have always seen our role as a catalyst for energizing states to recognize the dangers, to see a path to address those dangers, and to come together and share in the responsibility for the response.
Project Vinča repatriated some 48 kilograms of highly enriched uranium from the former Yugoslavia, and it was catalyzed by the Nuclear Threat Initiative's cooperation with the U.S. government. It couldn't have happened without the Nuclear Threat Initiative.
Nuclear material is all over the world that is relatively unsecured, and this launched in the U.S. government the idea, the concept, and the program called the Global Threat Reduction Initiative. Now we've spent hundreds of millions of dollars with the U.S. government, with other governments around the world, getting nuclear materials secured around the globe.
An important part of our mission in reducing nuclear dangers was to strengthen the International Atomic Energy Agency.
Nuclear Threat Initiative came where trailblazers, because through Warren Buffett, they offered $50 million as a seed money for the IAEA to establish a fuel bank.
The World Institute for Nuclear Security is a new organization that's designed to allow for the sharing of best practices among security officials responsible for nuclear material.
The biological threat also has huge implications.
One of NTI's important programs has been what we call CORDS, Connecting Health Organizations for Regional Disease Surveillance. It enables these countries to work together in ways that they otherwise would not.
That is the strength, the power of NTI as a trust-based, honest broker among all country government and intergovernmental organizations.
Is a former U.S. senator. Please welcome Senator Sam Nunn. Please sit down.
What is the Nuclear Threat Initiative? Because I'm on board if it means we should take the initiative in making nuclear threats.
No, it doesn't mean that. It means we should do everything we can to reduce nuclear threats and that...
NTI has taken its public education mission seriously from the beginning. We've done this through our projects, we've done this through our voice, through our communications, through tools like making films.
Excuse me, Mr. President. We have a situation.
I hate it when you say that.
Sir, we have a walk-in with some very disturbing news.
Consular office in St. Petersburg, sir. A man came in on 10 September claiming to have information about a plot to steal nuclear warheads.
NTI has had a role in really reshaping, redefining the way the public understands the nuclear threat.
In my own country, it has brought Democrats and Republican leaders together. Leaders like George Shultz, Bill Perry, Henry Kissinger, and Sam Nunn, who are with us here today.
NTI has been very lucky to be associated with four great American leaders. They called for the elimination of nuclear weapons and to work together in an urgent way on specific steps toward that vision.
It was like open a window. The fresh air came into this stale thinking which has been dominating discussions about nuclear weapons.
It became okay to say that getting rid of nuclear weapons was actually a strong national security position, that it was about making us safer.
We've made a lot of progress, and we have to make a lot more. And one of the best things that we could do would be to get rid of these nuclear weapons.
We have to ask ourselves as leaders and citizens, if we did have a terrorist nuclear attack on a city like Washington or Paris or some other great city in the world, what is it we would say we wish we had done? Why don't we try to do it now rather than waiting for the catastrophe?